Hello children, how are you? I hope you are fine. Today we are going to learn a lesson of EVS 1. Let us solve our own problems. What is this lesson about? For example, what problem we are facing now? The problem of corona. What is the solving? How can we solve that problem? What is told to us? We should wash our hands. We should use the sanitizer. When we are going out, we should wear the mask. And we should avoid contact with each other. We should stand or do not sit close to each other. So this, if is not done, then what will happen? This problem will go on increasing. Will it be removed from our society, from our social life, if we don't follow such instructions? So it is our duty in any problem that we should try to cooperate and follow the instructions which are told to us, or try to communicate with each other and solve the problems. And if it is not solved in time, it will grow bigger and bigger, and then it will be difficult for us to solve the problem. Paragraph, in the second paragraph, what is the point mentioned here? Solving dispute. It means that the thoughts of the people, yes, they do not say yes for one particular thinking. Yes, one says no, this thinking is right, this should be followed, and the other people, two or three of them, they say no, this method should be followed for doing or solving the problem. So what happens? They don't, one or the other is not tolerant, what we have learned. So they don't try to take aside their decision. They want both of them that our decision should be taken. So in this manner, can the problem be solved? No. Yes, they should try to solve it together and accept each one's decision. Then only the dispute or their thinking, yes, will be done or for the welfare of the people. It will be in practical for the people. If the dispute is serious, then they can make the leaders of the villages or the cities to give them a good decision, or to make their opinion common at one point and try to solve the problems or the dispute of that particular whatever the work they want to do, or any other, they can say something for the welfare of the society. Now every day in the news or in the newspaper, we are seeing that there is always a difference of opinion in two villages or border lines of our countries, neighboring countries. So there is some confusion between them. So how this can be solved? One of them accepts the some points of the other, and the other one accepts the points of the another person. Then together, if they come to one particular conclusion by communicating with each other, understanding each other's opinions, one of them can be tolerant. What we have heard about tolerance. If the people, they show understanding among each other, in this manner you can solve the disputes and you can progress. You can do the progress in your villages, cities, or in the country. Yes, you can progress in the neighboring countries also. There will be no problem or disputes among the borders of neighboring countries also. In this manner, if we communicate and accept each other's opinions, we can solve the disputes. Now this dispute, if it is not solved by talking with each other or communicating with each other. This paragraph given here, problem solving. If you have downloaded the Diksha app, you will come to know and you will see the whole, that is the name mentioned here is Hiware Bazaar. How they have solved their problem of the village. It is the example given to us. You can say it is a very good example how the villages or how that village has solved its own problem. It is particularly mentioned here in the lesson. In the village of Hiware Bazar in Ahmednagar district, what problem they were facing? A problem of water. How they solved the problem? With the participation of the whole village. The problem of grass or the food for their animals was also solved by them. What did they do? They growed grass for their animals in their surrounding. Then water problem was severe. They had very great problem of shortage of water. Then cleaning of village. Now you are knowing that Swachhata Abhiyan is being carried out by our Prime Minister. So one particular day is selected. Is it okay that one particular day only we should clean our surroundings, our houses, or where the places, public places which we use? Every day we should try to keep our villages, cities, our society clean. And we should not say, this is not my place, I am not staying here, or I am not using this place. We should try to take a group activity. We should try to involve the people and keep our surrounding clean. It is known as Shramdan, or work for the welfare of the village. We should contribute and cooperate and try to solve the problems of our own villages. The people of Khudawadi, it is given here in Usmanabad district, cleaned their own village. All the people cooperated, went together and cleaned their village. If you go there, you will see that their village is very, very clean. And the work done, it is given the name to it, Shramdan. Yes, you are giving Shram, means you are doing the work. That is called Shramdan. They decided everyone should help in cleaning the village. And the wastewater, the use of water, after using the water, where the water should be taken out, where the outlet should be, it should be underground, or it should not harm the air or spread the insects which harm our health, or the people should not get sick with that outlet of our used water. We should make proper outlets for the going of the waste water. The garbage we should throw in the dustbin and try to make some more use of that garbage and make manure. We have learned in one lesson, and we should use it for growing our crops. And toilet villages, some places, very remote villages, you can say in today's world, in very remote villages nowadays also, they are not having proper sanitation facilities or toilet facilities. We should try to build toilets for them and take the help of the government also, and we should use toilets. Sant Gadge Baba, who was a religious person, who used to say kirtans or give sermons on God, and he gave importance to cleanliness. Yes, he through his speeches, and when he used to visit different type of places, he used to make sermons or speeches on God also, and try to make people aware of the importance of cleanliness. He told people that cleanliness, education and self-reliant, we should not be dependent on others for solving our problems. He showed the people himself, he cleaned the villages personally, and he guided the people through his actions. His name was Rashtra Santa Tukdoji Maharaj. He explained the importance of cleanliness through his Gram Gita. Gram means village, or Gita is a holy book of Hindus. So whatever he preached for the importance of cleanliness, it was named as Gram Gita. One shloka is given here. You can read it on your own. Then newspaper also, they also highlight, or they make us known to the importance of cleanliness. If we don't keep clean our surroundings, our environment, what will be happen? We will get sick. We will always have to face the problem of health. So for a happy and healthy life, living life, the society, it should be in harmony, it should be in peace, it should be happy with each other. Then each and everyone has the right for its basic needs. Each person should be secure. He should not feel afraid of another person. And one person should not think that he is low. And he will always behave with him as I am superior and you are inferior. Such type of inequality in the social life will decrease the peacefulness of the society, the happiness of the social life, that is our human or the living world. Learning the importance of peace and try to be quiet and calm and try to solve the disputes, the civic issues, the problems in this manner will help for a happy life in our family, in our school and in our community. This lesson is over now. What you will read for homework, do you know? And try to find the question answers in your lesson. Everyone is having textbook from now, from the school. So you will find the answers and write the question and answers. Thank you.